Liverpool was really annihilated. Lord Street, Church Street, all on the docks flattened.
But that really did shock me when we got to Castle Street and see the area of devastation. It was frightening, that, for as a kid. And as soon as you heard an aircraft, you immediately looked at the sky and you'd listen for that throb.
And of course we used to pray that there wouldn't be a moon. You know, moonlight nights, they'd follow the river. You know, that was the hazardous thing with the Mersey.
A piece of the shrapnel fell by my foot. So I got my torch out, you know, and started looking for it. And you couldn't see a soul, but all of a sudden, there were about 100 voices shouted, "Put that bloody light out," you know.
I really couldn't see anything. The dust was just, when we got out of it, our hair was just white. It was a coffin and there was like big girders, big steel things. I just remember them hanging down, you know.
And I thought, I'm too young to die. I'm only 14.
My husband said, "You can't go back in the house. We've been hit." So I started screaming, "Where's the children? Where's my mother?" And he said, "They're all right. They've been taken down in the mission."
And I used to say, "I hate those Germans." And Dad would say, "You mustn't say things like that. There's nothing wrong with the German people."
Even after the war, long after the war, up till, let's say, about 1950, there were bombed houses and ollas, as we used to call them, wasteland, all around that area.
When you look back at it, the resilience of people was remarkable.
You felt a comradeship, you know, because you didn't know whether they'd be there the next day.